electric vehicles are the future.
We had 66% more hybrid sales in 2016 than we had in 2015.
In 2016, overall electric vehicle sales jumped 37% in the U.S. Manufacturers hope to boost that trend with affordable, long-range electric cars like the Chevy Bolt.
It is a 238-mile pure electric vehicle with a price under $30,000 after federal tax credits. This is a vehicle that is a seven-day-a-week, multi-passenger, multi-occupant, high-function vehicle. It's not just a great electric car, it's a great car, period.
That's a selling point for some consumers. Electric cars that are just as stylish, powerful, and roomy.
We're excited to launch the Chrysler Pacifica Hybrid, the first seven-passenger hybrid electric vehicle capable of carrying seven people and all of their cargo comfortably with a 33-mile all-electric range. We are not doing a limited rollout. These will be available for sale and service nationwide.
Minivans aren't the only new electric rides on the road.
Certainly there's going to be more competition in the electric space.
We're building a whole brand new family of electric vehicles. So that wouldn't just be Volkswagens, it would also include Audis and Porsches.
Ford's announced that we've got 13 new electrified vehicles coming by 2020, one of which is a midsize SUV that's all electric with at least 300 miles range.
As you get more cars going into the marketplace, the cost is going to come down. By 2025, we think that it'll be a wash in terms of the cost.
And manufacturers are addressing another long-standing problem, range anxiety.
We believe that more consistent range would get more people interested in electric cars.
We've introduced improved battery in our Focus Electric, so it's now, instead of being 78 miles range, it's 113-mile range.
We're going to be building cars with a range of probably 250 miles plus, and they'll be much more, you know, usable on a day-to-day basis.
The Mission E, in terms of the concept that we presented, wants to guarantee a 300-mile plus electric range.
You really can go anywhere you want to go.
Consumers not only have more options for vehicles, there are now more ways to charge them.
If you get the 240-volt set up in your house, you can reduce the charging time significantly.
And in a vehicle like Bolt EV, you can get 25 miles of range in an hour of charging at level two.
You go through a DC fast charging and you can get 80% of the charge in roughly 30 minutes.
The coolest way to be able to charge a vehicle would be inductively.
You can have wireless charging.
Instead of having to plug the vehicle in, you basically just drive the car over a pad.
We've got a coil on the ground where we start cycling current.
And the car inductively charges.
Imagine if all you had to do was pull into a parking spot and your car would charge.
There's a lot of talk and a lot of interest, but the real trick is translating that interest into action.
Our aim is to basically build 1 million electric vehicles by 2025.
It's only going to get better. At some point, people will say, okay, it's finally time for me.